Hello, I'm Nima Sharifi. I'm a medical oncologist and I direct the GU Malignancies Research Center at Cleveland Clinic.
Hi, I'm Xiuxiu. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at Cleveland Clinic.
We are excited to tell you about our paper just published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation on BMX regulation of 3-beta-HST1 and sex steroid biosynthesis in cancer. First, let me give you some brief background. Treatment of metastatic prostate cancer requires therapy with medical or surgical castration, which depletes testosterone in circulation. Although this treatment works for some period of time, resistance almost always develops and is termed castration-resistant prostate cancer, which is the lethal form of the disease. These tumors become resistant in large part because they make their own potent androgens, like testosterone and dihydrotestosterone from adrenal precursor steroids. The first enzyme that converts adrenal DHEA to potent androgens is 3-beta-HST1, which is encoded by the gene HST3B1. A hyperactivated or more stable form of 3-beta-HST1 that we call the adrenal permissive form and discovered about a decade ago increases how fast prostate cancer makes androgens from adrenal precursor steroids. This form of 3-beta-HST1 has been genetically linked to more rapid tumor progression in several prostate cancer clinical cohorts worldwide. The less stable form of the enzyme is termed adrenal restrictive, has slower androgen synthesis, and is linked to longer survival in men with prostate cancer. Altogether, this genetically validates 3-beta-HST1 as a driver of resistance clinically in men with prostate cancer. Now the question is there a way to block 3-beta-HST1 for treatment of men with prostate cancer who inherit the more active adrenal permissive allele? This is about 50% of men with prostate cancer.
To answer this question, I determined whether 3-beta-HST1 is phosphorylated and whether phosphorylation is required for 3-beta-HST1 activity and androgen biosynthesis. Of several phosphorylation sites on 3-beta-HST1, a single one, tyrosine 344, is necessary for activity. I found that making a phosphorylation defective form of 3-beta-HST1 blocks androgen biosynthesis. Next, I used unbiased methods to identify the kinase that is required for tyrosine 344 phosphorylation. I discovered that BMX kinase directly interacts with 3-beta-HST1 and is necessary for phosphorylation. Finally, I showed that genetic or pharmacologic inhibition of BMX blocks phosphorylation of 3-beta-HST1, potent androgen biosynthesis, and tumor progression in mouse prostate cancer xenograft models.
Importantly, 3-beta-HST1 is also one step upstream of aromatase, and Xiuxiu showed that BMX inhibition also blocks estrogen biosynthesis. This may be important for future studies in breast cancer. Back to prostate cancer, because BMX and BTK are closely related kinases, and BTK inhibitors are already in the clinic for other indications, we use these data to design a clinical trial through the Prostate Cancer Clinical Trials Consortium that's just started and is led by Dr. Raina McKay at UC San Diego. I will turn it over to Dr. McKay to tell you about the MAVERICK clinical trial.
Hello, my name is Raina McKay, and I'm a GU medical oncologist at the University of California in San Diego. I'm excited to talk to you today about the phase 2 study of abivertinib in patients with metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer, or the MAVERICK trial. This is a biomarker-selected, 2-cohort, 2-stage, phase 2 study with continuous safety monitoring, testing the efficacy of abivertinib in metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer. Abivertinib is a small molecule tyrosine kinase inhibitor that selectively targets BTK and BMX, which play a role in androgen biosynthesis. We hypothesize that the combination of abiraterone plus abivertinib in patients with the adrenal permissive HSD3B1-1245C genotype will have enhanced efficacy in both abiraterone naive and abiraterone progressing patients. This trial will enroll eligible patients into one of 2 cohorts. Patients who are abiraterone naive will receive the combination of abivertinib plus abiraterone, and patients who are progressing on abiraterone will receive the same combination. The primary endpoint of the study is 6-month radiographic progression-free survival. Secondary endpoints include objective response and duration of response in evaluable patients, PSA response, efficacy parameters in distinct subgroups, such as those with or without bone metastases, those with or without visceral metastases, and those having received prior chemotherapy. Additionally, we will evaluate safety, time to first SSE, symptomatic, subsequent anti-cancer therapy, and overall survival. There will be key correlative objectives, including the pharmacokinetics of abivertinib with abiraterone, in addition to pharmacodynamic tissue changes in paired tumor biopsies between baseline and cycle 2. Additionally, we'll evaluate mechanisms of response and resistance in baseline biopsy specimens and in serial ctDNA and circulating tumor cells. The inclusion criteria include those with progressive metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer. All participants must have germline testing for HSD3B1 with confirmation of the adrenal permissive gene. We are eager about this study as this is one of the first studies that is designed in patients with the adrenal permissive HSD3B1 allele. We hypothesize that this combination will result in enhanced efficacy to abiraterone.
We are incredibly excited that the mechanism we identified in this paper will be rapidly exploited in the MAVERICK clinical trial, and we eagerly anticipate the outcomes. Thank you for your interest and attention in our paper.